Hello guys, welcome to another quick tip. Today I'm telling you how to remove your ignition barrel. It's very easy to do it, and it applies to all kinds of Italian cars, all the way from the Alfa 155 to this day. All cars except the cars that have the intelligent key uses this kind of ignition barrel, and today I'm trying to explain how can you remove this ignition barrel without disassemble this part here. It's very easy and simple to see. Mind you, this part here, they usually break on this tab, and you have to remove these two screws to do it, but that can be for another video. Let's see here if I can explain to you how this works. Now, you have your corresponding key on your ignition barrel. You push it all the way and you can rotate everything with very ease. Okay, this is the normal function. If you press this tab here, you can also rotate left a little bit more, leaving your presence lights on, so you can signal your car whenever you want. That information is on your owner's manual. You can see in more detail when to use that function. So let's see here how this does this work. If you notice here, there is this little tab here, and we can rotate our key, and pressing on this tab at the same time, wait for the tab to go down. Okay, it's down. Let's keep the key on this position. Okay, it's very, very springy. And now it only enters in one position, because we have this lower part here. And sorry for the light. It's in. It is that simple, guys. You don't have to remove this whole part from your car, from your steering column, in order to remove your ignition barrel. I hope I am saying this right. I hope this part really calls ignition barrel. So to disassemble is the same. You have to, with a screwdriver or whatever you want, even the second key can do it. Press down on the tab like this, and turn and keep pressing with your screwdriver. Okay, it's down. Now jiggle it out. If you can see, the tab tends to come out. That is a safety feature. Okay, and it's out again. Now you can change or repair your ignition barrels, so you don't have a limited number of keys. Another thing, you don't need to code. I mean, in order to switch the ignition barrel, you don't need to mess with the code key. Okay, the code is read by the ring that is around this part, not this part. Okay,